Was Felicity Holland in there somewhere? Lying in the leaf litter, raindrops falling from the branches onto her unseeing eyes, beetles clambering over her moveless legs rather than going the long way round, while the quietly breathing trees kept their counsel. His muscles clenched with a fierce desire to get in there and search, not just to stand here on Dalton's leash and ignore her. If she was there, how long before another dog walker found her, and how much of her would be left by then? There was lots of wildlife in Burnham Woods. Foxes, badgers, stoats, weasels, carrion crows, not to mention all the patient, unsung clear-up workers who lived below, in the grass and under the soil, and did their bit for the ecology, tiny mouthful by tiny mouthful. The rain eased, and the smell of the woods came to him, wet and green and lovely. Perhaps there were worse places to see out eternity. Dalton interrupted his reverie. So they could have parked in the Stag car park and walked along a bit. Or, Slider forced himself to say, they could have been deeper in the woods, come out here and dropped the bag there on emerging. Possible, Dalton allowed graciously, and then extra gracious. If you find any evidence that your missing woman came to the beaches, I will be happy to extend my full cooperation. Then he spoiled it by adding, dependent on my superintendent's agreement, naturally. Naturally, Slider said. Seen enough. Shall we go? Said Dalton. He had a stout and venerable wax jacket over his suit jacket, and his shaved hair could not be spoiled by getting wet,